Hello students, today I am going to discuss about the chapter 2. Okay, in this chapter we will discuss about and we learn how to create database. Okay, so here you can see that in chapter 2 is log on to access. Okay, in this chapter we will learn about the concepts of database and DBMS, types and structure of database and etc, so many things. So first of all, I would like to teach you at first, okay, practically I would like to teach you how to create database in MS Access. Okay, for this purpose, first of all you have to click on a start button, you can see here. Okay, now you go on all programs. Okay, you can see here you go on MS Office. Okay, you just see where is MS Office. Here MS Office is given here. Okay, after that click on MS Access 2007. You can see here MS Access. You have to work on MS Access for creating the database. Okay, this is the main topic we have to learn. Okay, so when you click on this, you will see this. Okay, this is the window which appears when you click on the MS Access. Okay, so there are so many inbuilt database are also given here. Okay, inbuilt means what? This is called inbuilt templates. Okay, inbuilt means what? Already fields has been given. Okay, but by using the blank database you can customize by yourself, you can create your own fields, you can as per your choice, as per your requirement. Okay, so the in two ways database can be created. Okay, first by design templates. In these templates already fields are given, some just like you can see your contact. Okay, that means when you create this database, whatever the basic requirements regarding the contacts has been given. Okay, the field which required you can keep it, otherwise you can replace it. Okay, remove it. But here we will learn about the blank database. Okay, how to create database by using the blank database. Okay, so first of all you click on the blank database. After that you will see here a blank database. Here you enter the name of database, whatever you can enter. Okay, suppose I am going to enter Gyan Niketan. Gyan Niketan. So what can you see here? I have entered the name Gyan Niketan in this database. Now you can click on the create. Okay, as you create the database, you can see the window which appears in front of you. This is the database window. Okay, clear? This is the main database window. Here you can see the MS Access window. Okay, these are the basic components which have been marked. Okay, you can see here this component is called quick access toolbar. Okay, you can see here this is the save icon, this is the redo icon, and this is undo icon. Okay, so this area is called quick access toolbar. Okay, and that means this is used to perform this toolbar contains the frequently used tools. Okay, which we require time to time. Okay, so for by single click you can perform any task. These are called the tabs, just like you can see your file tab, home tab, create tab, external data, database tools, fields, etc. Okay, this is called tabs. Okay, after that, after tab you can see here, after tab this is called group. Okay, clear? This is called view group, this is called clipboard group. Okay, you can see here this is called filter and sort group, this is called record group. Okay, and each group has some commands, just like you can see here this is filter command. Okay, this is some command. Okay, clear? This is font color, this is bold. So in each group, this is just you can see here, you are familiar to this. This is called font formatting group. Okay, that means when you click on home tab, you can see the various groups. Okay, view group, clipboard group, sort and filter group, record group, find group, and text formatting group. Okay, in each group individually commands are there. This is bold command, this is italic command, this is underline command. Okay, so these are called tabs, and within tabs you will see various groups, and in groups you will see the commands. Okay, and first of all you see here, this is called title bar. What do we call this? This is called title bar. Okay, and this is the topmost bar present at the Microsoft Windows Access. Okay, and this toolbar contains the name of the database. Okay, after that this is the help. Okay, you can take the help, and you can see here, this is the whole section from here to here. This is called ribbon. This is called ribbon. Okay, so first of all each group has ribbon, and in each ribbon there is so many groups, and each groups contains the commands. Okay, and you can see here, now in next topic, this is called navigation pane. Okay, this is called navigation pane. Okay, that there may be so many tables in your in a database. Okay, in a single database there may be so many tables. Okay, so this is the student information, there may be some other also table. Okay, so you can jump from here to here. So this is called navigation bar, and this is called record navigation bar. What is this called? This is called record navigation bar. Okay, that means you can see here 7 records are entered, so 7 of 7 is given here. By using this button you can get ahead in next record. Okay, and by using this you can move to the previous, and by using this you can move to the first, and by using this you can move to the last. Okay, and the last, this is called a status bar. You can see here, this is called a status bar. Okay, this is called a status bar. Okay, and this is called view button. Okay, clear? So these are the components of MS Access. Clear? Now you can see here, first of all, for creating database I will move to the view button. I will click on the view button. Here you can see two views are there, design view and data sheet view. For creating tables we will go to the design view, and for entering data we will go to the data sheet view. You can see a design view. Okay, in design view first of all a dialog box will open. You will enter the name. Suppose I have entered the class 8. The name of this table is class 8. Okay, so you can see here there are so many fields name are given there. Okay, one by one you can enter. Suppose first is serial number. Okay, one thing you keep in mind, you don't have to enter any symbol. Okay, you don't have to enter any symbol in between the field name. Okay, you can use underscore in place of it. Okay, next you will see ADM and admission number. Next you will see name, after name. Clear? Okay, so you can after name a dialog box will open. You have to click okay. Serial number will be the data type of serial number will be auto number, because the serial number gets updated automatically as we add the new record. Okay, admission number will be of number type. Okay, name will be of name text. Okay, next I will enter the class. Class. Okay, in class you generally keep the text. Okay, because if you are keeping text, then you can enter text and number both, but if you have kept number then you are unable to enter the text. Clear? After that, suppose I am giving a mail. That means only two possibilities are here, yes or no. So you can take the yes or no. Okay, clear? A checkbox will appear. After that, date of birth. Clear? For date of birth you can see here date and time. Clear? And next I will give you photo for photo you can see the attachment, okay, attachment. After that hyperlink, okay, that means you have to enter email. For this purpose you can use hyperlink, okay, clear. Next, suppose rest leave it, okay. Now you go on the view again and click on data sheet view. You will see the to save the table. You save here, a database field has been created, and this is serial number. I had already told you, you don't have to enter the data in auto number, okay. Admission number, suppose my admission number is 1234, okay. And you can enhance the size of the field like this, okay. And manate hai, suppose that my name is Ravi Kumar. This is class 8A. If you are male, then you can check. Otherwise, not checked means you are female. Date for entering the date of birth, or calendar is given here. You select them. Suppose my date of birth is 10 January. So I will write here 10 January, and by you can edit here. Clear? And this is the attachment. You have seen that here photos will be attached. You right click, okay, right click mouse button, manage attachments, add option will be there, and from your drive you can add the image wherever the image will be present, picture will be present, okay. Suppose I am giving the sample picture, and suppose this is the picture you want to attach, and you can click on open, okay, picture has been attached. You can see you can attach more than one picture also in the same way, okay. You can open it again, okay. This is the picture preview, okay. After that you can close it, okay. Suppose you want to write your email, clear. Suppose that Ravi 1234@gmail.com, okay. This is the email. If it not visual, you can enlarge it, okay. So first field has been created, okay. After that you enter the second, okay, 1212, okay. Suppose this is the, you know, adoption, clear, 8C, clear. And suppose this is if not male, okay, clear. Now suppose November, in November his date of birth is okay 2005, okay. For attachment you right click and go to the manage, okay. So you can select any picture, okay, clear. And here you can enter the roshan@gmail.com, any type of email, okay. In this way you can create the database, and you can enter the records to the table, okay, clear. After that you save the table, okay, and then you can close it, okay. Your database has been created. So this is the first step. I have taught you how to create database in MS Access. In next class I will discuss about some other ways to create the database, okay. Thank you.